This is a reading comprehension passage with a set of four questions. Let's look at the first question. What, according to the author, is the reason behind confusion in science? See, author says that there is no one theory that can explain things really well, and whatever understanding we have is we are only on the edge of it. And as soon as it gets more complicated, we pass it on to someone else. We don't really delve into it. And that is why the correct answer to this question will be D, a lack of good theory that explains things better. Option A says the abundance of difficult questions. No, he's not saying that there are too many difficult questions for us to answer. He's saying that we don't delve into difficult things or things that are too deep. We stay at the edge, and although the edge might itself be very complex, but that does not mean that we have too many difficult questions. Option B says an absence of theoretical data. He's not really commented on empirical or theoretical data. Option C says an excessive focus on simplicity. It is not that science is trying to focus on simplicity. It is that it is able to achieve depth only through simplicity. And that is why physics, he says, has achieved a certain level of depth. So correct answer to this question will be option D. Between biology and history, which subject is deemed to be more complex and why? Author says that physicists, when the things get more complex, they pass it on to chemists. And chemistry, when things get more complex, pass it on to biology, and biology pass it on to history, and history to sociologists. Which means that history will be more complex than biology because it attempts to answer questions that biologists have given up on, and hence the correct answer to this question will become option C. Next question says, who would the author of this passage consider more intelligent, a physicist or a sociologist? Now, all the questions that are, when questions get complex, physicists pass it on to chemists, and chemistry always pass it on to biology, and biology to history, and history to sociologists. That only means that sociologists would deal with more complex questions than a physicist would. This does not comment on their intelligence at all. Hence, the correct answer to this question will be option D. Next question says, how does the author describe the real world? He's saying that the real world is messy and it's intriguing and it's complicated, because that is why he gives example of Galileo, who was able to study once he realized that he has to eliminate friction and or air resistance before he can really study motion. Hence, the correct answer will be option B, intriguing and messy.